we take a closer look at Florida high school football.
Name is Patrick Ledan, Felix Varela Sr. High, and last year we went 3-7 in our independent league. It's really good for our program, Coach, man. When I first got to Varela, we were doing fairly well. We were in the playoffs the first 2 years I was there, went against Homestead. Then you fast forward, man, we need to get into this league. And going into this league gives us a chance to be competitive.
Gotcha.
You know, and we're real excited about the 21 class, man. That 21 class, I came in, I said in the interview, we're going to focus on the 21 class. And now the 21 class, man, it is the class that we put all our chips in.
Okay.
You know, and I'm getting goosebumps talking to you about it. These are great kids. They've been, some of them playing since freshman year, you know. This is going to be the year that we hope they really break out.
Okay, all right. So let's talk about you personally. Favorite athlete / football player. Could be anything. I don't want to limit you to football.
But okay.
Who would be your top athlete, period?
I'm embarrassed, Coach. I'm not the same person anymore. my last favorite football player was Terrell Owens, man.
Okay.
I like the swag. I like the type of person that's gonna tell you what they're gonna do to you, and then they're gonna go out and do it to you, and nothing you can do about it. I like Terrell Owens in the NFL. Then when I look about basketball, I guess I was, whenever there's hype, I want to kill the hype. So Jordan was the man, so I went Reggie Miller. I went with Charles Barkley.
You that guy. You're going
yeah,
to
get man. Yeah, man.
Great.
When Jordan retired, I was like, okay, who do I go after? And I found myself, and this is actually where I started to fall in love with coaching. I fell in love with Coach Popovich in the San Antonio Spurs, and Manu Ginobili became okay. My favorite athlete. And just the way Pop... it's not just basketball with them, you know, it's culture,
yeah,
family. And I'm like, yeah, that's bigger, because if you get the right kids in there and they believe in culture, they believe in family, that's when you get the alumni coming back. I'm a Florida State guy. I went to Florida State.
Okay.
But it's dope to grow up in Dade County and see the UM alumni on the sideline.
Yeah.
That always stood out to me. And I want that from our program. Okay. I want the alumni coming back. And I want them tuning in.
Been the head coach, you said, now for 3 years. When it comes to coaching, what were the major reasons that you said, I want to be the head? It's a lot different than being the assistant. Why be the head?
I believe it started, that's who I am. And I didn't realize that growing up, that, you know, there's that phrase, born leader, and all that. I think it's in my personality, and I had to learn how to be more patient.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's in my personality to want to take the reins.
Okay.
Like, all right, man, you're not doing this right. Just let me do it. Just sit back. I got it. You know,
uh-huh.
I had to learn a certain amount of patience. I'm glad I was an assistant for as long as I was, because I can appreciate what it takes to be a follower.
Yeah.
And I truly believe that a good leader is a great follower. So I always had aspirations. Once I decided I wanted to be a coach,
mm-hmm.
I had aspirations to be a head coach.
Okay.
Now, I didn't know what I was saying to myself then, right? Oh, I want to be a head coach. I didn't know at 22 what a head coach would really mean. And now at 33, like, yeah, I wish I could go back to that 22-year-old kid. Like, slow down, man. Just be an assistant for a while. But yeah, I think it's my personality. I don't mind being a follower. I do not. I do not mind being a follower whatsoever. But there is a sense of wanting to lead.
I got you. Being competitive, how does that fit in your program?
I'm laughing because the last word of our team Zoom today was compete.
Okay.
It's something that we do every single day, and I live it. And the message to the kids today was compete with who you were yesterday and just get better. Yeah, and we try to do our best to the phrase is ignore the noise. We tell them ignore the noise. You know, outside people are going to compare you to this person and that person. Well, just compete with yourself, you know, if you get better every single day. So what we do in our periods. You know, we have best on best coach. We have different scenarios. In fact, the walkthrough practice, so the day before the game, the last period is scenarios. And the DC just comes up with these outlandish scenarios you find yourself in, you know. Yeah. Hey, coach, the ball's on the 40 going in. You have 12 seconds, one timeout. Oh, shoot. Here we go. And somebody's going to run after this, you know. Yeah. Offense or defense, somebody's going to run after this. And you get the guys really barking at each other, really coming into that scenario the right way. What I love so much about those scenarios, never did one player complain about the scenario itself.
Gotcha.
Like, oh, we only have 12 seconds. Oh, that's not fair. No one ever said that. Like, okay, we have 12 seconds and we're going to win.
Gotcha.
But the very least we're going to do is compete. We're going to compete. So, yeah, it's embedded, coach. It's embedded in what we do. They hear that word every single time we speak to them.
Okay, good. Good. All right. And you just answered the next question, because it was like, how do you make it fun? And it sounds like just coming up with these different scenarios, it's not so much the scenario. The emphasis is on that competitive part. What can I do to contribute? So that's good.
Absolutely right. Absolutely right. And the other thing about that scenario, what we like so much is, so one of the times the offense was in a really bad predicament scenario, we saw something very similar that day, the next day in that game. And we called the play that we ran against them, and we scored a touchdown off of it. And everybody, you know, in the crowd is going nuts, and our sideline's kind of calm. Our business manager comes back, and she's like, is this the play you told me about in practice yesterday? I'm like, yeah. She's like, that is baller. I'm like, it so happened it worked out, you know? It's just the way the world worked. You know, we prepared for that. I'm reading Pete Carroll's book, Win Forever, and he was talking about his time at USC, saying something along the lines of he wanted to make sure kids played without fear.
Gotcha.
So put them in whatever scenario you can, so that if that scenario happens in the game, it's not, oh, what the hell is this? Like, we've done this before. We can handle it. Let's go. Gotcha. So, yeah.
Okay. So let's say we don't know what's going to happen, but let's just say everything starts on time. We get out there, we're playing, throwing the ball around. Who are you looking for as leaders, as playmakers, and just being on the team? Who are some of those names that you have?
Coach, Dominic Medina, our quarterback. He's going to have a hell of a year. You know, this is a guy that came into our program as a freshman, and coach, he played linebacker for us.
Oh, God.
Then the next year, he was the backup quarterback, but our defense was thin. He played linebacker again, no complaints. So this past year, his junior year, he played quarterback for us, finally got into that role. He's going to have a breakout year. Our starting middle linebacker, Kaalen Teixeira, this guy is the man. He's the man of our program. Everybody knows whatever, we call him Tex. Whatever Tex says, that's what goes. And it's so convenient, right? Like, to have that middle linebacker be that guy, to be that voice, to be that bat, if you will.
Okay.
So he's going to have one guy on Dress Martinez, all 5'6", 5'7" of them. And let me tell you what, anybody in our district, they know you better cover number 13.
Okay.
Yeah, this guy is quick. He's special. He's special. And what I'm telling these college coaches is, hey, you see him on this paper, you're not happy about it. I know. Watch his film. And we had like 3 or 4 guys like, oh. And they go check his GPA, check his test score. Okay, coach, we need to talk to him. I'm like, I'm telling you, this guy is special. And he's fortunate, right? He's fortunate for the guys of Edelman, Welker, Tyreek Hill. Like, people are getting more in tune of, oh, you might be small, but if you can do something special, then you can definitely play. So those three names are the big three names for us for sure.
Okay. And then as far as any young guys coming up in the ranks, anybody that's chipping, you know, just, hey, I want to get in. I want to contribute. I want to be that guy.
Absolutely. Kennedy Walker is a guy that plays defense for us. Kennedy is a real cerebral guy. Very, very, very intelligent. He's the type of guy, he's texting me all the time. Hey, coach, I'm watching film. Was I supposed to fill here? Should I have backpedaled? Because he's learning the game, and he's asking so many good questions. In fact, I have some coaches with less experience on my staff, and I told them, hey, Kennedy's going to make you a better coach because you better know your stuff for a guy like Kennedy Walker. And then on offense, we have a running back, Gavin Greaves. Mm-hmm. Again, not much to the eye. And I'll never forget this player because when he came to us as a freshman, he was on our scout team. And I was like, hey, man, take pride in scout team. You know, light these guys up. Mm-hmm. Let them know who you are. And then one day I'll go over to him and say, hey, man, what is your biggest strength? And coach, as you can imagine, I'm thinking speed, hands, quickness. The dude said vision. He said, Vision, man. Like, that's his nickname now. We all call him Vision. And he shows it. He shows it because he's not the biggest guy. He's not going to run you over every single time. But he's going to make that cut, set the next block. He's going to get you on balance and then try to run you over. Kennedy Walker on defense and Gavin Greaves on offense will definitely be the first few names that come to mind. So, obviously, we had guys come in right before COVID. So, like, January, February, they came in. Because we had this one dude, Evan Sanchez, who's 6'7". You know, he's definitely going to get some colleges walking in our building.
But I was going to ask you, I said, okay, let's go with the season. Season starts. Mm-hmm. It sounds like you're already talking to your players, using technology and everything else, which is great. Yes. But let's say it's the first time you actually get to see them face-to-face. What are some words that you would actually say to them to start the season?
What our slogan is, I think the first words I'll say to them is, it's a great day to be a Viper. You know, that's something that we say. Coach, I can't wait to see my guys again, man. I can't wait to see my guys again. Just because I know the promise that we have. I know what we've been trying to build. I thought about, it's interesting that you said that, and going back to Coach Carroll, I thought about our first meeting. And besides just saying it's a great day to be a Viper, I want to hold the football up. I'm watching this show on Netflix about a premier soccer team. And it's a real good docuseries, I think, for any coach because we can relate to it. It's showing the emotions of the city, what goes on in the front office, what goes on with coaches and players, and just the passion people have for their sport. And you know South Florida, you know football. Mm-hmm. We're very passionate about it. And Varela's starting to be very passionate about their football. And Carroll talks about how it was Matt Leinart that was talking about how Carroll will hold the football up at a team meeting and say, this ball right here holds the hopes and dreams of so many mm-hmm. and the grief and sorrow of those people too. Be responsible when you hold this ball. Don't lose it. Go after it with all cost. And I want my players to hear that message. I want them to know that it's bigger than just our locker room. We're going to ignore the noise by all means, but just understand that our actions, people are looking at us because they want us to succeed. Right. And I want them to understand that our soccer team, I'm going to steal this from them. Our soccer team, our coach makes them, they have like a bandage, if you will. Mm-hmm. They take their risks. And they're supposed to make markings. And I was asking, what are these markings, like these tally marks? Some people have two, some people have five, coach. I'm like, what is this? And someone finally told me, you got to remember, these are a lot of kids from Colombia, from Venezuela, right? They said, we're supposed to put who we're playing this game for. I'm getting chills talking to you about it right now. Every single person that comes to mind, you're supposed to make a tally mark. And I want our players to do that. I want them to remember that, hey, ultimately it's your life. Just remember that this is bigger than us. You know, this is about the guys that came before you. These are about the guys that are going to come after you. And be responsible with that so much. So, yeah, we're going to talk about that.
Last question.
Yeah.
What is a question that you wouldn't want me to ask you?
How do we beat Braddock? We haven't figured it out.
Okay. I'm actually going to talk to him next. I'll ask the secret sauce.
Right. You know, again, it's always great to talk to coaches because everyone knows a life. The question of, how do you beat this team or how do you beat that team? Like, man, there's so many variables that go into it. Mm-hmm. You know, I hate that question. You know, I give them a generic, we're going to stay healthy, we're going to try to, and we're going to go compete. But that's it. Like, you know, I'm going to tell you, we're going to hit the A-gap 14 times in the first quarter. What do you want me to say to you? You know, there's so many variables that go into it. So yeah, that'll be the question. Or if you were to ask it, I would have gave you a generic answer. Like, all right, coach, yeah, you got it, man. You got it. Gotcha. I don't know how we're going to beat these teams. But I know how we're going to prepare. I can tell you that. You know, we're going to prepare to compete and hopefully win that game.